Hey guys, so today's video is going to be my foundation routine, specifically my really dewy foundation routine. Recently I have been going for really dewy skin. I just love how it looks. I love the glow on the cheeks. So I really wanted to share this with you guys. It is using mainly drugstore products. Not everything in this video is drugstore, but my foundation is drugstore. And my concealer and my highlighting powder, mainly what makes me dewy is drugstore. I was actually wearing this exact look in a recent video where I was reviewing the Balm's Read My Lips lip glosses, and a lot of you guys were like, wow, your skin looks so fresh and dewy, show us how you got that. And I was like, absolutely, I will. So I thought it was a great idea. I have been loving this look anyways, so I decided to make the video. This is going to be a talk through video because I feel like I don't do those very often. So I hope you enjoy that. So if you want to see my really dewy foundation routine, then just keep watching. If you hear my dogs in the back, they're acting a fool right now. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is prime my face. I always prime my face right before foundation. These dogs. And the primer I'm using is my Too Faced Primed and Poreless. This is just a little sample size I got at Sephora. And I'm just adding it to the places where my pores show the most. So the foundation I'm gonna be using is my Maybelline Fit Me Foundation. I am in the shade 220. This is the shade I have when I'm self-tanning, which I am currently. And I usually love my foundations with a beauty blender, but for this specific foundation, I love using my Makeup Geek foundation stippling brush, only because I feel like it is already dewy and it shears out nicely on its own that I don't need my beauty blender. I love my beauty blender on like thick foundations or more full coverage foundations, but something like a BB cream, a tinted moisturizer, or a nice dewy finish type of foundation, I like this brush. So I'm just gonna dump some on the back of my hand. Just about this much. I don't really need a lot. I feel like it does a really good job of just blending out my skin tone. Not blending out, evening out my skin tone. And I just love how natural this foundation looks. It looks crazy because it's a lot darker than my face, but it matches my body. This foundation seriously is so ideal for girls with dry skin. I have dry skin and I love it. My face just drinks it up. And I'm getting a little sick, so I probably sound a little raspy. It honestly just takes no effort to blend. And the finish is just so fresh and dewy and pretty. I definitely see people with oily skin not liking this because, I mean, I'm dewy. But I think people from normal to dry skin would really like this. The only thing I'm not too crazy about is that it kind of stays just a little bit tacky on the skin, and that's usually like a major pet peeve for me. I cannot deal with tacky foundations, but I mean, it's to be expected with something so glowy and dewy. And if that bothers you, all you have to do is set this with a powder and then you're good to go. And it takes away like the majority of the tacky feeling. So the next thing I do is I go in with some concealer, and today I am using LA Girls Pro Concealer and the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. I'm just gonna take the Pro Concealer and put it right underneath my eyes to cover dark circles. This concealer has amazing coverage. So I like to use it with this foundation because this foundation doesn't cover like 100%. But I mean, I would say it covers pretty decently. I don't have like super problematic skin, but I do have like redness and uneven skin tone, and it covers pretty well. I'm just gonna add a little bit of this concealer, like this. And then I am taking this up into my forehead to highlight, and around my mouth to cover up the veins I have. I like to blend this out with my Real Techniques contour brush. Oh, one of my dogs farted hardcore. Woo! That's fun. pungent. I'm gonna drag some up onto my eyelids because I'm just doing a foundation routine, so I'm not gonna do much or anything to my eyes. What's so great about this Maybelline Fit Me concealer is that it blends so well. Honestly, I use this as a foundation all the time. I'll take the shade 10 and I'll put it on my entire face and use it as a foundation. That was like my holy grail foundation like a year ago. It was amazing. I still do that. And it's not as dewy as the foundation. So if you want something less dewy but still love the blendability, I would use this all over your face because it works amazingly well. By the way, I'm not sponsored by Maybelline. I'm just a very big fan of the Fit Me line. I think it's so great, especially for us dry-skinned girls. I'm gonna take my e.l.f. small tapered brush and I'm gonna set my under eye concealer with this MAC Emphasize powder. This is so great if you want like a really like glowy looking skin because it has like shimmers in it. Not like crazy shimmers, but it just makes your under eye look nice and bright. I'm gonna take some and just brush it on my eyelids. So now I'm gonna work a little bit more on that glow factor and I'm going to add a liquid highlight or a cream highlight and then go on top of it with a powder highlight. It's just gonna make you look extra dewy and glowy. I'm gonna use my BB Plus Illumination Facial Cream by Gerard Cosmetics. I bought this myself. Gerard Cosmetics did not send this to me. I have heard crazy good things about this stuff, so I decided to buy it myself because it's just right up my alley. I love illuminating creams and all that good stuff. But the packaging on this sucks. I feel like nobody comments on that, on how the packaging is so terrible. And I think it might be just me, but when I ordered it and I got it in the mail, the packaging was so bad that there was cream leaking out. So I emailed them and I was like, there's cream everywhere. It doesn't even pump out. Like the pump was not working at all. So they sent me another one and I'm having the exact same problem with the new one they sent me. Nada. So I have to take it out and apply it to the back of my hand and then use it that way, which is a pain in my arse, but I deal with it because it is a really pretty product. So I'm just gonna take my e.l.f. Flawless Concealer Brush and I'm gonna dip it into that Gerard Cosmetics facial cream and I'm gonna apply this to the tops of my cheekbones. Just a little bit on the bridge of my nose. And now I'm just gonna go in with some bronzer. When I do a look like this where it's very fresh faced and dewy, I don't like to do that whole contour thing. I just wanna give my face a little bit of a bronze. Just a little bit of definition, and I'm gonna be using my Sephora Sol de Rio bronzer. I've gotten so many questions if I still use this, if I still like it, and yes, it's probably one of my holy grail bronzers, but I don't like to use it in videos because it was limited edition and I don't wanna upset anyone. If you can get your hands on this bronzer some way, somehow, and you are like medium to light skin tone, do it. It's so good. So I'm gonna take my Real Techniques blush brush and I'm just gonna add some bronzer. I'm gonna quickly curl my lashes. I know this is random doing this step now, but I'm just gonna curl my lashes and add some mascara. Okay, so now it's my absolute favorite part of this routine, and it is my highlighter, my powder highlighter. I recently bought this not too long ago, and it has become my ultimate obsession. It is the Physician's Formula Shimmer Strip in Natural Nude. So I like to take my little Sigma contour brush because it's the perfect size. I like to dip it right into these two little squares right here at the top because it has more of like a white gold and a gold color, and I love those white gold champagne type of highlights. So I'm just gonna dip my brush in and apply it to my cheekbones. And right here, take some right here. Okay, so now after that, I am pretty much done. But what I really like to do is take my highlighting powder and a little brush like this and add some to my brow bone. And I really like doing this, especially when I don't have any eye makeup on, because I just think it looks so nice on its own. And then I will add it right here. And then I just add any lipstick or lip gloss. I'm using my NYX Butter Gloss in Eclair. And that's it. I didn't add blush to this look today because I wasn't wearing blush in that video I did when I was reviewing the Balm lip glosses. But I just really wanted to share this foundation routine with you because it has been my go-to foundation routine recently. I'm going out at night and stuff. I really have been loving super dewy, fresh skin. I love it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really, really hope you enjoyed this video and that the talk through wasn't annoying. Please give this video a thumbs up if you did like it. And please subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.